I guess what we're asking today is, have your passwords been pwned? One of the websites I use to keep secure online is haveibeenpwned.com. Right, now, I love this website, it's great. Run by a guy called Troy Hunt. And whenever there's a big leak, let's say a company gets hacked and all these usernames and passwords get leaked out to the internet, obviously people who are trying to crack passwords and break into your accounts, they're gonna be looking at these things. But what he does is he collects them and lets you know. You've got an email address that you use for most of your accounts, you put this in the website, and if that email address ever appears in a leak, I assume probably tied to a password, but not necessarily, it will let you know. And that's a really good thing, because no one's on top of all the leaks, right? I certainly am not. And so maybe I have an email address I want to make sure hasn't been given away. So this is a great website, you know, we'll put a link to it. But actually, this is not what we're talking about today. What we're talking about today is the password API that he's also put online, right? Which is another great asset. This is where you can actually send in your password, in a manner of speaking, and it'll tell you whether it's ever been leaked. Now that's important, because if your password has ever been leaked before, by you or by someone else, then it could be appearing in a long list of words that are being used for a dictionary attack, right? And that just makes your password much more vulnerable, right? And in general, I would argue that if your password has been leaked before, it's not really safe to use. There's some interesting questions here. Should you be putting your password into a box on the internet that says, we'll tell you if it's been hacked, right? In general, no, right? In general, be very careful about where you type in your password. Even if I make a website and I say you should definitely trust me because it's me, don't trust me, right?
Just no one.
You know, for a start, I might just be inept at programming and have got a vulnerability, right? So this uses an interesting mechanism called k-anonymity to make sure that you can send in your password and find out whether it's in this big database of passwords, and no one gets to find out what it was, right? Which is using hashing, and it's really great. So we're going to talk about that now. So you can go on to haveibeenpwned.com/passwords, and you can type in your password there, and you can look at the source code, and it's probably okay. But actually, it's got a REST API where you can actually visit specific URLs and obtain information on whether your password is in that database. And you can do this very often. So you could do it, for example, for all the passwords in your collection, right, in your password manager. And actually some password managers, like 1Password, actually do this automatically for you. And they check your passwords this way. But, I mean, that's a really good idea. If you type in a password that you think is great for a new website, your password manager can say, actually, this one's already been leaked, like previously, so don't use that one. Right? So how does this work, and how does it remain secure? Right? Because even if this website is fully trustworthy, it's not a good idea to be sending a hashed version of your password to this website, right? This is a website that has all the lists of all the passwords. If yours shows up, suddenly your IP address is saying, my password's weak. And that's just not a good thing you want to have happen, right? So how does this work? Well, just like with all passwords, we hash it as a start to begin protecting it. So let's imagine I have my password, which is, you know, password 1. Now this is where we link to the video where I said don't use that password. If it's any variation on the word password or has any of the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 in order in it, you need to delete those passwords, maybe delete your account out of shame. Now this will be hashed using SHA-1, which for this purpose is okay, right? You wouldn't necessarily permanently store your passwords in this format, but for this API it's okay. And that's going to produce 160-bit hash, right? Which might look something like FA2241C... for 160 bits, right? Is it 160 bits? Yes. Okay, now, the problem is, if I send this off to the website, I've just given them my password. I mean, not quite, because SHA-1 is a hash, but that could be broken, especially if my password is not good, right? And also, he's got a bunch of these passwords and hashes already computed in this database. So as soon as he sees that I've got the hash, he looks, reverse looks up the password, that's a vulnerability, right? I trust the guy, but I still wouldn't want to do that, right? And so this API uses a system called k-anonymity. What happens is, instead of me giving them the whole hash, I give them just enough of the hash that they can give me back anything that might match, and I am the one that actually finds out whether it does, right? And that's a really neat trick. So I will give them the first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 characters of the hex of this password hash. So I will send the Pwned password API FA224, for example, and it will send me back some number of passwords that have been leaked in the past whose hashes begin with those 5 characters. Now, there'll be a lot of them. There's some 550 million passwords in this database, which is kind of scary. And it will return to you all the passwords that could match this and how many times they've been seen in leaked passwords, right? And usually you'll get about 400 or 500 back, right? That's when you go through the list yourself at your end and say, okay, actually my password is or is not in there, right? Because there's gonna be a lot of possible hashes and possible passwords that start with these five characters. This is called K-anonymity. The idea is that the website only knows we're one of about 500 people that could have this password. It doesn't even know actually if we have one of these passwords, which is quite nice, right? So I've written some code to do this and we'll have a look.
Before you get the code out, if you've hashed it with SHA-1, is this just the way that this system works that it uses SHA-1, or is it, I was just trying to work out, because surely the passwords might have been hashed in all sorts of
exactly. ways. It isn't the case that these passwords all were originally hashed in SHA-1, right? This database includes both the plain text and the hashed versions. These are passwords that have previously been cracked, right, as opposed to leaked in hashed form. So for example, maybe my password has been leaked in like bcrypt form and no one ever broke it, right? In which case it's of no real concern. I mean, it's better than it would never have been leaked, but you know. So these are passwords that have been leaked and have ended up in plain text, either because they were already in plain text or because they've been cracked and are now in plain text.
So you've got some code done?
Yeah, let's have a look at some code. So the first thing we can do is just poll this API directly. Very easy to do. You simply go to a web address part of which is the beginning of your hash, and then we try that, right? So let's give an example. So I'm gonna use curl, right, to obtain a website back. Just gonna send an HTTP request and receive a response. Curl is just a software library that I'm using here to send off a request to a specific address, and whatever website or data comes back, I'll receive that onto the command line. So it's gonna be curl, HTTPS, it only works through HTTPS to make sure there's encryption involved, api.pwned.passwords.com/range/, and then the prefix of my hash, which in this case was FA224. So FA224. That's gonna come back, it's done it, with a big long list of all the possible passwords that they have that start with that hash. Now it doesn't return the FA224, it just returns the other bits because it's a waste of time. Now some of these have been cracked or seen maybe one time. This one's been seen 169 times. I have no idea what it is. I'd have to break the password to find out. Given that it's been leaked 169 times, it's probably not very strong.
Maybe it's password one.
Yeah, it could be. You can try any of your passwords this way. All you have to do is take your password, hash it, right, which is easy to do on a command line, or I've written some Python code, and then we can fire it off to this API, the first few bits, and then we get back a list. We look through the list to see if our full hash is in there, and if so, our password has been broken. So I've written some Python code that will do this exact thing, right? So all it does is it uses the cryptography library, which is a great library in Python, to hash the password in SHA-1. It takes the first five characters of the hexadecimal representation and it sends them off to the password API. It comes back with, let's say, 500 of them. I split it all up, I look through and try and find my password. And if I find it, then it'll print that it's found, right? And obviously, I should change it. Now, of course, I'm just typing this with random passwords, but you get the idea. So let's have a go. Python, I've called it pwned.py. And then let's use this one, password one with a capital P. So it's been found, the hash actually starts with 70 CCD, and it's been found 111,000 times. That isn't great. What that means is that in different leaks, this password has occurred 100,000 times, right? It's definitely in the password list, right? It's a prime candidate. We already knew this, it's password one, right? Let's try something a little bit more difficult. So let's say password 1234, this is gonna be in there, it's only 3,000 times, right? But it's still not very good. If your password appears any number of times, just one, then that means that theoretically someone that had access to this list, and these are all publicly available, these leaks, could put that in their big, big long list of things and just try them as a matter of course on any new leak that turns up, right? So it doesn't mean that you're definitely gonna get hacked, it just means that there's a chance, right? And it's not ideal, so why not have a look and see? So, I mean, so we've used this password, perhaps we should use something slightly stronger. Any ideas?
In the password cracking video, I love you, Kate, was it?
All right, let's try that. So, I love you, Kate. All right, there we go. It was found 93 times.
I think some people might have started using it.
I mean, please don't use that password. You know, it's very nice, but yeah. Yeah, I mean, any password that appeared in that list is going to be is breakable enough that it's definitely going to be in there, right? So that's a huge problem. You know, if you start to get in slightly more difficult passwords, like some of the ones that we were looking at maybe in the choosing your password video. So for example, four words. So let's say,
why don't you do correct horse battery staple?
That is definitely in there, and I can tell you without even running it. Correct horse battery staple. was found 114 times. No, people, we don't use correct horse battery staple.
What about but using your tip of putting a random character?
All right, so
in
if I take correct horse battery staple, and let's say I put a star in the middle of here, so correct horse bat star OE staple, right? Not very pronounceable, right? Then we'll find that it wasn't found in the dictionary, right? Don't use it now because it will be in there now. But this is the idea. So make unexpected changes. But it's very easy to just poll this API, right? And just see, you know, is this new password I'm trying already in there, right? And if it is, don't use it. That's quite simple. If you're using a password manager and generating most of your passwords at random, they're unlikely to be in there, but you never know. And it just makes it that much weaker if they are.
Okay, shall I ask you, how do you say that?
Pwned, is it?
Pwned.
I don't know. I mean, if I'm wrong, then I'm a noob.
I thought you were elite.
Definitely not.